Charles Denton Tex Watson, born on December 2, 1945, is an American murderer who was a central member of the Manson family led by Charles Manson. On August 9, 1969, Watson and other Manson followers murdered pregnant actress Sharon Tate and four other people at the house of Benedict Canyon, Los Angeles. The next night, Watson traveled to Las Feliz, Los Angeles, and participated in the murders of Leno and Rosemary LaBianca as a part of Manson's Helter Skelter vision. Watson was found guilty of murder and imprisoned in 1971. Watson was born in Farmsville, Texas, on December 2, 1945, and grew up in nearby Cobbville. He was the youngest of three children. Tex grew up apparently attending the Cobbville Methodist Church. In high school, he was an honor student and athlete and worked as the editor of the school paper. In September 1964, Watson moved to Denton, Texas to attend North Texas State University, where he joined a fraternity. In January 1967, he began working at Braniff Airlines as a baggage handler. He used free airline tickets to travel and visited a frat brother in Los Angeles, there he became interested in the psychedelic lifestyle of the late 1960s. On August 8, 1969, Watson went with Susan Atkins, Linda Kasabian and Patricia Krenwinkel to a house occupied by movie actress Sharon Tate, Jay Sebring, Wojciech Frokowski and Abigail Folger. Watson, who had been to the house on at least one other occasion, climbed the telephone pole near the gate and cut the phone line. When an unknown car approached driven by an unwitting 18-year-old named Stephen Parent, Watson ignored his pleas for mercy and shot him four times in the chest and abdomen. After pushing the car further up the driveway and traversing the front lawn, Watson cut the screen of the window and let Atkins and Krenwinkel in through the front door. Upon Watson's direction, Atkins found the house's three other occupants and with Krenwinkel brought them to the living room. Watson tied Tate and Sebring together at the neck with rope and slung it up over a beam. After shooting Sebring and taking $70 from Folger's purse, Watson stabbed Folger seven times. The next night, six Manson family members, Leslie Van Houten, Steve Clem Grogan, and the four from the previous night, were driven into Los Angeles by Charles Manson. In March 1986, Manson and other family members had attended a party at the rented house of Harold True in Las Feliz. Manson did not want to kill True because he thought it could be traced back to him, so he settled for the house next door, where Leno and Rosemary LaBianca lived. After driving their car up and down the street and waiting, Manson and Watson got out of the car, disappeared walking up the driveway and entered the home together. According to Watson's book, Will You Die For Me?, Manson held the occupants at gunpoint while Watson tied them up. Manson returned to the car to say he had tied up the house's occupants and sent Krenwinkel and Van Houten into the house. Rosemary LaBianca was taken to bedroom by Krenwinkel and Van Houten as Watson murdered Leno LaBianca in the den. Rosemary LaBianca was then murdered in her room, primarily by Krenwinkel and Watson, with additional wounds inflicted in her back by Van Houten. Both victims were stabbed numerous times and the word war was carved into Leno LaBianca's stomach. A fork was also left protruding from his stomach. Phases from or inspired by the recent Beatles lyrics such as War, Helter Skelter, Rise, and Death to Pigs were smeared on the walls and various surfaces in the victim's blood by Krenwinkel. On October 2, 1969, Watson fled the ranch and headed back to his native state of Texas. On November 30, 1969, Watson was arrested in Texas for the Tate LaBianca murders. He and his lawyers fought the extradition back to California for 9 months. Upon returning to California, Watson began regressing to a catatonic state. He stopped talking and eating and lost 55 pounds. He was admitted to Atascadero State Hospital for 90 days evaluation period to determine if he was fit to stand trial. He stayed there until February 1971 when he was deemed able to stand trial. On October 12, 1971, Watson was convicted of 7 counts of first-degree murder and 1 count conspiracy to commit murder. A week later, the same jury took only 2.5 hours to determine that Watson was sane. On October 21, 1971, Watson was sentenced to death. He escaped execution when the California Supreme Court's People Anderson decision resulted in the invalidation of all death sentences imposed in California prior to 1972. Watson was found guilty of the murders of 7 persons and his 7 counts were to serve concurrently. His minimum eligible parole date was November 26, 1976, but he has been denied parole 15 times since then. He was most recently given a 5-year denial of parole at a board hearing on October 27, 2016. He remains incarcerated at Mule Creek State Prison in Ione, California.